Hello, my name is Harika. I am from BVC Engineering College. In this lecture, I will talk about feedback amplifier's characteristics. In last videos, we have studied about characteristics of your feedback amplifier. So that is transfer gain, stability of the gain, nonlinear distortion, noise distortion, frequency distortion. Left there is a input and output resistance. Now we'll see that especially that the input and output characteristics of the negative feedback amplifier. So we already know that there are four types of negative feedback amplifiers: voltage series feedback amplifier, voltage shunt feedback amplifier, current series feedback amplifier, and current shunt feedback amplifier. First of all, we discuss about the voltage series feedback amplifier input and output resistances. And this diagram is shows that voltage series feedback amplifier. So in this feedback amplifier, that input mixing is the series mixing and output is a voltage sampler. So now see here, the voltage series feedback amplifier represents the voltage sampler as a series mixing, and the output voltage is sampled and applied as an voltage to the mixer. Here the input signal and output signal amplifies the voltage, so that the basic amplifier is a voltage amplifier. And this amplifier stabilizes the voltage gains. The feedback voltage is directly proportional to the output voltage. So that's the reason why that output voltage coming from the feedback network VF is equal to the beta into V naught. So that input applied to the basic amplifier, that is VI, is equal to the VS, the signal source, minus your feedback signal is a VF. So therefore, the total signal source we can write it as Vs is equal to the Vi plus beta to V naught. This figure shows that the basic amplifier is the voltage amplifier that is replaced with its Thevenin's equivalent. So like this, this is represents your basic amplifier. And for this amplifier, the total feedback amplifier, if we observe, so the with respect to the feedback, that input resistance is represented with the Rif. And only the input of your basic amplifier is the Ri, and the output from your total feedback amplifier is the Rof, and including your load resistance is the Rof dash, and only the basic amplifier, the output is the R naught. So from this one, we can define the input resistance of the feedback amplifier. So feedback amplifier, the feedback amplifier, Rif is equal to total signal source is the Rs. Signal source is the Vs by input current is a Ii. So without the feedback, this is a simple. So that is Ri is equal to Vi by Ii. So now the input signal is a voltage signal. Apply KVL to the input. So then the signal source Vs is equal to the Vi plus Vf. So we all know that the Vi plus Vf is equal to beta V naught. So that total signal source Vs is equal to Vi plus beta V naught. So but we note that V naught is equal to the this one. So the V naught is equal to Av into the Vi. So that's if you substitute in this equation. So V naught is equal to Av Vi by RL plus R naught into RL. So where your Av is gain with the load resistance is a RL. So therefore your Vs is equal to Vi into 1 plus beta Av, where Av is a voltage gain without the load resistance is the RL. Now substituting your equation 3 into, so then your feedback, with feedback the input resistance Rif is equal to the Vi into 1 plus beta A by Ii. So that Vi by I is nothing but the input resistance of your basic amplifier. So therefore your Rif is equal to the Ri into 1 plus beta A. So with series mixing, that we can tell that with series mixing, the input resistance of the feedback amplifier is increases. Now we can see that output resistance of the voltage series feedback amplifier. To calculate the output impedance, the signal source Vs is equal to the 0. So the output impedance with the feedback is given as Rof equal to V naught by I. Applying KVL to the output loop, so that is a Av Vi plus I R naught minus the drop across this one is a minus V naught equal to 0. So then we can calculate your I is equal to V naught minus AV VA by R naught. So from this figure, the VS equal to 0, then your VI is equal to the minus VF. So that is also equal to the minus beta into V naught. Now substitute your equation 2 in 3. So that is then you will get the I is equal to V naught plus AV beta V naught by R naught. So that is I by V naught is equal to the 1 plus AV beta by R naught. So therefore the total output resistance with feedback is equal to the V naught by I. That is equal to without the feedback resistance R naught by its fraction, that is 1 plus A beta. So from voltage sampling, the output resistance is decreases. Now to calculate the total ROF dash, that is including your load resistor, so that is equal to the ROF parallel to the RL. So both are is in the parallel. Just if you see that diagram, you can get this idea again. So ROF parallel to the RL. So just after taking the parallel combination of this one, so we'll get this expression is equal to the RO dash by 1 plus AV dash beta. So here is the RO dash is equal to the R naught RL by R naught plus your RL. So whereas the AV dash is equal to the AV RL by R naught plus RL. So these are the input and output resistance of your voltage series feedback amplifier. Just for summarizing of these values, so then your voltage gain is equal to the V naught by VI, feedback factor beta is equal to VF by V naught, and D sensitivity is the 1 plus beta A, and voltage gain with feedback is AF is equal to A by 1 plus beta A, and the input resistance is RI, so 1 plus beta A. So this is increases the series mixing is increases the input resistance, and the output is voltage sampler, so that is decreased. So ROF is equal to the R naught by 1 plus beta A. So examples of this voltage series feedback amplifier is in the BJT is a emitter follow circuit, and whereas in the FETs we can consider go with a source follower, that is a common drain amplifier. Next we'll see the voltage and feedback amplifier, and this block diagram is shows that voltage shunt feedback amplifier. So here in the voltage shunt, here we are using the mixing is the shunt mixing, so that is the signal source must be the current source, and the output is the voltage sampler. Okay, this is the voltage sampling connection. So here the input is a current and output is a voltage. So the basic amplifier you are using in this voltage shunt is a trans resistance amplifier. The output voltage is sampled and applied as a current into the mixer. Here the sample signal is the voltage and the feedback signal is the current. That means the feedback network converts the signal from voltage to the current. For this, the input signal is the current and the output signal is the voltage. So that the trans resistance amplifier, that transfer gain we can define is Rm is equal to the V naught by II. This is a trans resistance amplifier gain notation. Now the feedback current is directly proportional to the output voltage. So that is IF is directly proportional to the V naught. So that IF is equal to the feedback factor beta into V naught. Now that input resistance of the basic amplifier is calculated just by the basic amplifier is replaced with its equivalent circuit. So in that replacement of your equivalent circuit, so this figure shows that replacement of your basic amplifier, that is a trans resistance amplifier. So the input is replaced with your resistance is RI and output is a voltage source, that is RMII. So the RM is called the basic amplifier gain. So after just if you substitute this one, and this is also equal to the output voltage is a V naught. So this is a basic replacement of your trans resistance amplifier. Now with respect to this one, that input resistance RI is defined as input voltage is a VI and current is a II, and input resistance with feedback is RIF. This one is RIF, that is equal to the signal source is a IVS by II. So here is a signal source we are representing. So in terms of your voltage, we are representing the Vs by II. Now we can calculate that. So that input signal is the current. So applying the KCL, so then your Is is equal to the If plus II. So but your basic amplifier gain, so that is your Rm is equal to V naught by II. So your II plus beta V naught. So your II plus beta Rm II. So that your II is just if you come from that one, we'll get the 1 plus beta Rm. Therefore, RIF is equal to the VI by IS. So that value is equal to VI by II into 1 plus beta Rm. So therefore, with feedback, the input resistance of the voltage shunt feedback amplifier is decreases. That is RI by 1 by beta Rm. So that from we can understood that the shunt mixing decreases the input resistance. Next is the output resistance calculation. So in the output resistance calculation, just here also the signal source IF equal to the 0. Then the output resistance with the feedback RYF equal to the V naught by I. Applying KVL to the output loop, then your Rm II plus I R naught minus V naught equal to the 0. So from this we can write your I is equal to V naught minus Rm II by R naught. If Is equal to the 0, so then your If is equal to the minus II. So from this one, then your I is equal to V naught plus Rm beta V naught by R naught. So your I is equal to V naught if you common from your numerator. So then your V naught into 1 plus Rm beta by R naught. So that RYF equal to V naught by I. So the R naught by 1 plus beta Rm. So from this we can tell that sampling, voltage sampling is decreases the output resistance. Now see the output resistance is ROF dash. So that calculate your ROF dash, just we can go with your R naught dash. So just R naught dash is a parallel combination of ROF parallel to the RL. So just after substituting these values, so then we'll get this expression. So that ROF dash is the RO dash by 1 plus beta Rm dash. So that is RO dash is equal to the R naught RL by R naught plus RL. So with feedback, Rm dash is equal to Rm by RL by R naught plus RL. So just if you see that summary of this voltage and feedback amplifier, the trans resistance of the basic amplifier is Rm. So that is equal to V naught by II. Feedback factor beta is equal to IF by V naught. And D sensitivity is the 1 plus beta Rm. Input resistance with feedback is RIF is equal to RI by 1 plus beta Rm, and output resistance with feedback is ROF equal to R naught by 1 plus beta Rm. So in the voltage shunt feedback amplifier, because of your shunt mixing, input resistance is decreases, and voltage sampling, that output resistance is also decreases. Next is the current series feedback amplifier. So the sampling and series mixing. Here the current is a sampling, and also that mixing is a series mixing here. Here the output current is sampled and applied as a voltage into the mixer. The sample signal is a current and the feedback signal is the voltage. And the feedback network converts current into the voltage signal. So the basic amplifier input signal is the voltage and the output is the current. So that here the basic amplifier is a transconductance amplifier. It is a transconductance amplifier has to used here. So this stabilizes the transconductance. Here the beta is equal to Vf by I naught. So that is equal to Vf equal to, and here is the amplifier is the transconductance, not your trans resistance. That is a transconductance amplifier. Now the input without feedback, the input resistance Ri is equal to Vi by II. With feedback, RIF equal to the Vs by II. So apply KVL to the input, so that total signal source is the Vs minus your drop of input is a Vi, and minus your feedback signal is a Vf equal to the 0. And we are having your I naught is equal to Gm Vi by RL plus R naught into RL current is. So VI plus beta V naught, that is equal to G, that GM is equal to V naught by VI. Therefore that RIF is equal to VI by IS. So just by substituting your IS value here, so then we'll get that II by VI by II into 1 plus beta RM. So that is VI by II is written as an input resistance is RI. So that is RI by 1 plus beta RM. So that is RIF equal to RI by 1 plus. So that input resistance with feedback RF equal to the RI into 1 plus beta GM. So GM is the feedback basic amplifier voltage gain. That here is a basic amplifier is a trans conductance amplifier. The trans conductance amplifier gain is a GM. So here the current series, here is the mixing is a series mixing, so that series mixing is increases the input resistance. So that is RIF equal to RI into 1 plus beta GM. Next, the current series output resistance. So to calculate the output resistance, make your signal source VS equal to the 0. The output impedance with feedback is RYF, that is equal to V naught by I. So applying the KCL there, I plus GM VI is equal to V naught by R naught. So if the VS equal to the 0, so VI is equal to the minus VF, so minus beta I naught. I naught and I is in the opposite direction, so that's the reason why here we can write as beta into I. So substituting your equation 3 in the 2, then I plus GM beta I is equal to the V naught by R naught. So V naught by I is equal to RYF is equal to R naught into 1 plus beta GM. So the current sampling output resistance is increases. So here the total RYF dash, that is here, that is equal to the RYF parallel to this, RYF parallel to the RL. Just we can calculate that by substituting all these values. So that is RYF dash is equal to the R naught dash 1 plus beta GM by 1 plus beta GM. So where your GM is equal to the GM R0 by R0 plus RL. So that is including with the load resistance is the RL. If RL is infinity, then your GM is equal to the 0. And RYF dash is equal to R0 dash into 1 plus beta GM. So then your R0 dash is also equal to the R0. Like see the input and output resistances of your current shunt feedback amplifier. This block diagram shows your current shunt feedback amplifier. Here the output current is a sample and applied as a current into the mixer. The sample signal is a current and the feedback signal is also current. The input signal to the basic amplifier is a current and the output of this is also a current. So that the basic amplifier used in this negative feedback amplifier is a current amplifier. This amplifier stabilizes the current gain, so that is AI, that we can define as output current is I naught by input current is II. The feedback factor beta is equal to the output we are getting is the current is IF and input of the feedback current is I naught. So beta is equal to IF by I naught, and from that point that IF is equal to the beta into I naught. So here the basic amplifier is replaced with its Norton's equivalent. So as shown in this figure, so from this the feedback without the feedback RI is equal to VI by II, with feedback RIF equal to VS by IS. Now in the input side just apply the KCL, so then your IS is equal to IF plus II, then your I naught from your output, that we can add as your current division rule. According to that current division rule, I naught is equal to AI II R0 by RL plus R0. So your IS is equal to II plus beta into I0. Then your I0 by II, so that is AI is equal to AI R0 by R0 plus RL. So without load resistor. So that is that from that we can write as II plus beta AI II. So then your with feedback, that input resistance is RIF is equal to RI by 1 plus beta into AI. So now we see the calculation of your output. So So to calculate the output resistance makes your signal source, that is the current source IS, equal to the zero. So the output resistance with feedback RYF equal to the V naught by I. So applying the KCL at your output, so I naught equal to AI II plus I. If I is equal to the zero, I is equal to minus IF, so that is equal to beta into the I. So therefore, so that is AI beta I plus I is equal to the V naught by R naught. So that RYF is equal to the R naught into 1 plus beta into AI. So here that the current sampler is increases the output resistance. So these are the calculation of your RYF dash. So the RYF dash is the RYF is parallel to the RL. So just by solving this one, we'll get your where your this expression. So that is your, and here is the AI is equal to the AI R0 by R0 plus RL with the load resistor, that is. So RO dash is equal to the R0 dash. So R0 dash is equal to R0 RL by R0 plus RL. So if the load resistor RL is infinity and AI equal to the zero, then your RYF dash is equal to R0 into 1 plus beta AI. Then your RO dash is also equal to the R0. Now see that characteristics of your negative feedback amplifier. How this characteristics is varies from different four types of your negative feedback amplifiers. So in the previous videos we learned about how to calculate your voltage gain, bandwidth, distortion, noise, and now in this video we understood that input resistance and output resistance of the four negative feedback amplifiers. Now this is the comparisons of these four types of negative feedback amplifiers. If the voltage gain, so the voltage gain of your current series is decreases, and again your voltage series is also decreases, voltage shunt is also decreases, and current shunt is also decreases. And the bandwidth of the negative feedback amplifiers is increases, and harmonic distortion of your negative feedback amplifiers, any type of the negative feedback amplifier, the harmonic distortion is decreases by a factor of 1 plus beta d. And the noise is also decreases for the negative feedback amplifiers. Now that input resistance of the current series, here is the mixer is your series mixing. So for the series mixing, so that input resistance is increases. So current series, the input resistance is increases, and the voltage series also, that input resistance is increases. So whereas in the voltage shunt and current shunt, here is the shunt mixing. In the shunt mixing, that input resistance is decreases. So voltage shunt decreases and your current shunt is also decreases. And coming to the output resistance, in the output resistance, that voltage sampler is decreases the output resistance, and the current sampler is increases. So therefore, in the current series, that output resistance is increases, and in the voltage series, so the output resistance is decreases, and again the voltage shunt also, the output resistance is decreases, and current shunt, that output resistance is increases. So these are the differences of these four types of your negative feedback amplifiers with this input and output resistances. Now we said that how to identify the topology of your negative feedback amplifiers. Identify the feedback element, which is nothing but the common element connected between the input and output amplifier. If the feedback element terminal is connected to the output voltage, then it is voltage sampling. Otherwise, it is the current sampling. If the feedback element connected to the ground, then it is a series mixing. Otherwise, it is a shunt mixing. So in the basic circuit diagram, if you they given, so in the diagram, just we can identify what will is which element is acts like between the input and the output. So from that identifying the feedback element, now we can understood that what is the type of the sampling and the mixing. Once you know that the sampling and the mixing, we can tell that which type of your feedback amplifier, that is the voltage, series, current, shunt, like that. Now see the advantages of your negative feedback amplifiers. So the advantages of the negative feedback amplifiers is bandwidth is increases. So if the bandwidth is increases, means the distortion free zone is increases, the distortion is decreases. Frequency and phase distortions also decreases. Overall gain is decreased. Effect of the noise is decreases as gain is decreases. Nonlinear distortion is decreased as the gain decreases with meets the requirement of the amplifier according to the feedback arrangement. That input resistances with feedback RIF and ROF are increased or decreased in order to meet the requirement of the amplifiers according to the feedback arrangement. Now, applications of your negative feedback amplifier. Feedback amplifiers are mainly used in control theory. So, using the mixer of a method, state space controls, full state feedback as forth. So, this is used in the control theory. So, like this. This is an example diagram for that. And a climate change feedback. The climate system is expressed as a strong positive and negative feedback loops between the process that affect the state of the air, ocean and the land. Climatic changes from the warming. Next, this is also used in your electronic engineering to increase the stability, to increase the bandwidth, to reduce the distortion. So, in the electronic cases, these are the applications of your negative feedback amplifiers. Just now, we'll see the some numericals related to the negative feedback amplifier. So, let us see here in this problem, a voltage series negative feedback amplifier has a voltage gain without the feedback is 500. Input resistance is 3 kilo ohms and output resistance is 20 kilo ohms and the feedback ratio is 0.01. So, calculate the voltage gain, input resistance, output resistance of the amplifier with feedback. And in this problem, they mention that voltage series negative feedback amplifier is they mentioned. So, for the voltage series feedback amplifier, we already know that what is its input resistance formula and output resistance. And first we write that at the given values. So, what is your values is given in the problem. So, like this. After writing that one, first we can calculate the voltage gain with feedback. In the feedback amplifiers, that voltage gain is decreased with a factor of 1 plus A beta. So, from that one, AF is equal to A by 1 plus beta A. So, after substituting all the given values, then we will get these values, this one, 83.33. So, we all know that the gain is not having any units. So, input resistance with feedback. Here is the voltage series negative feedback. Here the type of the mixing is the series mixing. So, for the series mixing, the input resistance is increases. So, that input resistance is increased by with the factor of 1 plus beta A. So, therefore, that input resistance with feedback is RIF is equal to RI. This is your RI. So, RI into 1 plus beta A. After substituting these values, then we will get the 83 kilo ohms. Now, the output resistance. So, that output is a voltage sampling. So, in the voltage sampling, the output resistance is decreases. So, that ROF is equal to R naught by 1 plus beta A. So, after substituting these values, then we will get your output resistance is 3.33 kilo ohms. So, just by seeing your given values and again your obtained values, if you observe, in the given values that 500 is the gain. But in the feedback, the gain is decreased to 83.33. Whereas in this without feedback, its input resistance is 3 kilo ohms. With feedback, that input resistance is increased. And your output resistance, if you observe, that is 20 kilo ohms without the feedback. With feedback, that output resistance is decreases, is 3.33 kilo ohms. For voltage series negative feedback amplifier. Let's see the another numerical. So, in the current series feedback type of an amplifier has the following parameters. So, they mention the input resistance and your RI. Sorry, they mentioned in the diagram. So, that is R1, R2, HIE, RL, RE and HFE. So, calculate A, beta, RIF and AF of the loop gain in decibels. So here for the amplifier, so that the simplified model, that current gain of this amplifier is equal to minus HFE RL by HIE. So for your basic amplifier values, this from H parameter analysis, we are having that formula is equal to minus HFE RL by HIE. So after subtracting these values, the gain is a minus 40. And your RI is equal to the input impedance is a HIE. So that is RI equal to HIE, that is equal to the 2 kilo ohms. And the beta is equal to RE by RL. The feedback element is in commonly acts like in your emitter resistance. So RE and by RL. So that is 0.1. So that is RIF is equal to HIE plus 1 plus HFE RE. And your AF is equal with feedback is also like this. That is a minus HFE RL by RIF. And loop gain is value is A beta. So in decibels that value is 5.04 dB. Thank you.